Welcome to another video by Battlefront Living History Group Malta. When we usually think about the air defense of the island of Malta during the Second World War, the 40mm Bofors gun is one of the first images that come to our mind. However, in the greater picture of the war in the Mediterranean, the Royal Navy in particular made use of another system of a similar caliber that was to be as important as the Bofors itself. During the Second Boer War at the end of the 19th century, British forces encountered the Maxim Nordenfeldt 37mm gun in use by Boer forces. It was an upscaled Maxim machine gun design, featuring the same mechanism and a water-cooled barrel, but capable of lobbing explosive shells at a substantial rate of fire. Maxim Nordenfeldt had been acquired by Vickers in 1897, and the British Army was quick to adopt the 37mm gun, pressing it into service during the Second Boer War as a light artillery piece. However, it was during the First World War, with the advent of use of military aircraft at a vast scale, that this gun in particular, designated by the British Army as the quick-firing one-pounder, found renewed use as a light anti-aircraft gun in the trenches of the First World War, even at the back of trucks, and also in defense of the British Isles against Zeppelin attacks. The following year, after briefly trialing a new, upscaled 1.5-pounder variant, the Royal Navy adopted an even larger successor, the 2-pounder Mark II, for anti-aircraft use on its ships. It fired a 40mm shell from a rimmed cartridge some 158mm long. Following the end of the First World War, the British Navy found itself encumbered by a huge stockpile of 2-pounder ammunition for its quick-firing 2-pounder Mark II anti-aircraft guns. It was also around this time that the Royal Navy started looking at the concept of a short-range, multi-barreled anti-aircraft system capable of high rates of fire. Both Vickers and Armstrong submitted designs. The Armstrong design was more complicated, whereas the Vickers design built on the earlier Mark II that was already in service with the Royal Navy. Allegedly, the huge stockpile of 2-pounder ammunition mentioned earlier was a major reason for the Royal Navy adopting this design as well. Trials were first held with a 6-barrel design in 1921 and 1922. Nevertheless, due to a funding deficit that plagued the Royal Navy as it did many other militaries around the world, it was only in 1927 that the first firing ground trials were held. Sea trials were held the following year, and it was only in 1930, so around 8 years after the first prototypes were being tested, that the HMS Valiant was fitted with a single mount. It took some convincing before the Royal Navy allocated more funding to the procurement of more of these systems, now designated the 2-pounder Mark VIII, on its other vessels. 8-barrel mountings were initially developed for larger vessels of the Royal Navy, though quadruple mountings for smaller vessels and single-barrel mountings for corvettes and motor torpedo boats were later developed. One remarkable advantage of these systems were the high-capacity magazines, each able to stack a number of 14-round steel-link belts. The octuple system, for example, permitted the loading of 10 belts, or 140 rounds per gun, for a total of 1,120 rounds. The single-barreled mount still permitted the loading of 4 belts, or 56 rounds. The octuple mount, especially after modification allowing it to fire on fully automatic, permitted a cyclic rate of fire of 115 rounds per minute per gun, and effectively permitted the entire system to fire for 73 seconds without reloading. Though the controlled mode on the quadruple and the single systems allowed them a slightly slower rate of fire of around 80 to 100 rounds per minute, this was still deemed to be a high rate of fire. It was also noted, however, that the dated 2-pounder ammunition used lacked sufficient velocity, and shortly before the Second World War, high-velocity ammunition was developed. And while most of the new systems were manufactured to that standard, conversion kits permitted previous versions to be updated for use with new high-velocity ammunition. This ammunition, together with updated director designs, kept the system from becoming obsolescent at the outset of the war. The reports on the 2-pounder during wartime initially appeared to be mixed, with reports of frequent stoppages, and in particular, unfavorable accounts in the Far East at the end of 1941. An account in particular claimed that a single-barreled 40mm Bofors gun was more effective than an octuple 2-pounder mount and director control, particularly on account of the Bofors tracer ammunition. However, according to Martin Middlebrook and Patrick Mahoney, such an account remained unsubstantiated by any confirmation of hits registered by Beaufort's guns in the same action, whereas several hits were registered by 2-pounder mounts. John Campbell does claim that the Beaufort's gun was deemed twice as effective in countering torpedo-armed aircraft, but both systems were also seen to be equals in bringing down Japanese suicide planes. It is evident that with updated directors and regular maintenance, the system worked extremely well, partially owing to its proven Maxim design. In the Maltese context, for example, HMS Illustrious fired no less than 30,000 rounds in January 1941, with very few recorded stoppages. During the many arduous convoys to Malta, not least Operation Pedestal, in August 1942, where even the obsolete Mark II is seen pressed back into service on period photographs, the 2-pounder remained a common and welcome sight. The Beaufort's 40mm gun was never really meant to replace the Vickers 2-pounder system during the Second World War. And through this conflict, the Vickers system remained the predominant light anti-aircraft gun system used on Royal Navy vessels, greatly outnumbering the Beaufort's guns that were pressed into service in the same application. What we have here is two examples of British 2-pounder shell casings. This one is the standard brass shell casing. As you can see, it has been fired. That's dated 1943. And what we can see here and appreciate is the small size of the cartridge case itself, so limiting the amount of propellant that is being carried, which obviously has an effect on the effective sealing of the 2-pounder system as it is being used, an effective sealing of approximately 3,000 meters. Next to it here, we have a drill round of the same exact system. As you can see, it is machined from a single piece of steel, and it is also meant for the 2-pounder Mark 8 system. What we also have here, however, is, for size comparison's sake, an empty cartridge case, as well as a cutout of a 40mm Beaufort's cartridge. And the reason why we are comparing them is for the simple fact that the Beaufort shell casing is much larger. And this was one of the reasons why you usually find reports of the Beaufort's gun being superior, presumably because it is putting up a much more effective sealing than the Vickers 2-pounder system is. In fact, we're looking here at a cartridge case length of approximately 311mm as opposed to the 158mm of the Vickers 2-pounder.